An update on the weather now. Severe tropical storm Chedeng is unlikely to bring heavy rainfall to the Philippines in the next 3 to 5 days. State Weather Bureau Pag-asa said Chedeng was last spotted some 1,090 kilometers east of central Luzon. It is packing maximum sustained winds of 95 kilometers per hour. The storm, though, is expected to enhance the southwest monsoon, which may cause gusty conditions over the Visayas, Romblon, Occidental Mindoro, as well as parts of Mindanao. Chedeng will likely develop into a typhoon tonight or Friday morning, but it is expected to maintain its distance from Philippine landmass. Taal Volcano's sulfur dioxide emission level is declining, but state volcanologists say volcanic tremors and degassing activity are still being recorded in the volcano, which is still under alert level 1.
Kahapon, in fact, the volcano island spewed out steams that are around 2,400 meters high. And yesterday, sulfur dioxide emission medyo bumaba naman from 7,680. The previous day, nagiging 5,780 na lang kahapon.
Meanwhile, VOG, or volcanic smog, remains a problem for residents near the volcano in Batangas. The Provincial Disaster Management Office says some people are experiencing runny nose, common colds, and itchiness of throat. The PDRRMO also distributed 10,000 units of N95 masks, which are proven most effective at filtering ash.
Due to the high volume of smog being emitted by Taal Volcano, classes are still suspended in municipalities of Bagoncillo, Balete, Laurel, and Tarlisay. We still insist that the people should be warned of not going to the island of Taal Volcano, not to be complacent, but be prepared to whatever things might happen when worse comes to worse, individually, by family. And of course, please make sure that they are having their N95 masks when they go out.
President Marcos vows to boost ties with countries which host overseas Filipino workers. He says this will ensure their safety and welfare. The president sent his message to OFWs Wednesday to mark National Migrant Workers Day in the country. The Philippines is locked in a labor dispute with Kuwait, which recently banned the entry of new Filipino workers. Kuwait claims the Philippines violated a bilateral labor agreement.
We understand the challenges that you face, being far from your loved ones, adjusting to new cultures, and overcoming barriers. And that's why this administration will continue to foster stronger ties with countries that host our migrant workers, ensuring your safety, welfare, and well-being. As you build your dreams in far-off lands and seas, do know that you are not alone.
Labor and trade officials in the Philippines team up to help returning overseas Filipino workers start their own businesses. Now, the partnership of the Departments of Trade and Migrant Workers aims to encourage migrant workers pursue business ventures. Migrant Workers Secretary Susan Ople says they will conduct financial literacy and entrepreneurship training. Trade Secretary Alfredo Pascual says OFW products and services can be included in trade fairs.
We would want our OFWs who are aspiring to become business owners to have mentors in their respective provinces, and also to get proper guidance from the DTI on how to go about putting up a business of their own.
Despite the dismissal of 2 of 3 of her drug cases, detained former Senator Leila De Lima's bail petition has been denied. A Muntinlupa court on Wednesday junked De Lima's petition, ruling that the evidence of guilt is strong against her and the other accused. The bail request is in connection with the third drug case, which accuses De Lima, her former aide, and 5 others of running an illegal drug trade at the National Penitentiary. De Lima has denied the allegations, but the court said there was evidence of conspiracy to commit illegal trading. The court also rejected De Lima's invocation of humanitarian grounds, saying the former lawmaker is not suffering from any serious or life-threatening health condition. For Philippine Justice Secretary Jesus Crispin Remulla, the denial of former Senator De Lima's bail petition is all due to her lawyers. Remulla blamed her lawyers for not filing a writ of habeas corpus instead, which is a remedy against illegal confinement. He tells De Lima's camp to respect the court's decision.
Sinabi ko na dati yan, we would not have objected. If there is a petition for bail based on humanitarian grounds, because siya, after all, 6 years na siya, 6 na taon na siya nag-iintay. Sana yun na lang sinulat nila at nag-iintay muna yung kanyang mga abogado. Sinabi na namin na hindi namin talaga papalagan kung gano'n ang naging dahilan. Pero mas gusto nila magpasikat ng gano'n eh. O kaya magparinig at magpahiwatig na ang tingin nila eh, kayang-kaya nila yung kaso. Yun ang kanilang desisyon eh.
The camp of detained former senator meanwhile slams the Justice Secretary's remark. Her lawyers assert humanitarian grounds were actually cited in their bail petition.
I'd just like to also point out that the humanitarian ground was actually part of the petition for bail of the defense of former Senator Dayo de Lima. That's first. And secondly, the fact that she is not also a flight risk was cited by the defense. So I think if the Secretary of Justice will just read through the petition thoroughly, those points were actually cited. And in fact, the court said that even despite the attempt on the life of Senator de Lima, that particular incident was not taken by the court as enough to actually grant bail on humanitarian grounds. So humanitarian grounds was cited by the defense at the camp of Senator de Lima.
De Lima's camp also says the bail petition denial is not at all surprising since she's been politically persecuted. Despite the setback, they remain unfazed as they plan to appeal the court's decision.
And Senator Ray de Lima's camp will exercise the remedies available to her to question the order. We will question the order. We do not want to actually discuss yet to the public what are our possible next moves. But definitely, what I can announce is, of course, we're going to question the motion, the order through a motion for consideration.
A grave injustice, that's how Leila de Lima's allies described the court's denial of her bail plea. ACT Party List Representative Franz Castro calls it a blatant disregard for human rights and the rule of law. Progressive group Bagong Alyansang Makabayan echoing the same sentiment. It says de Lima's continued detention is proof of the country's deeply flawed justice system. Philippine Senator Risa Ontiveros also condemning the court's decision.
Nakakadismaya ang patuloy na pagkakulong ni dating Senador Leila de Lima. Karapatan niya ang isang mabilis na paglilitis gaya ng nakasaad sa ating konstitusyon. Nananawagan ako ng agarang at malinaw na resolusyon tungkol dito. Itigil na ang kabulastugang ito. Tigilan na ang pagpapahirap kay Leila.
U.S. Senator Dick Durbin also weighing in. He calls the court's decision tragic and a sad day for human rights champions in the Philippines. Another U.S. Senator, Ed Markey, says de Lima's continued detention is unjustified. U.S. lawmakers led by Markey visited de Lima in detention last year. Human rights groups also slamming the denial of de Lima's bail petition. Karapatan says it is unacceptable that the former senator has been detained for 6 years due to baseless and politically motivated charges. For the Human Rights Watch, the court's move only prolongs de Lima's suffering and worsens her political persecution. Amnesty Philippines calls the decision deeply concerning. It urged the Marcos administration to release de Lima.